The Alhambra Tower in Kuwait City is one of the tallest buildings in the world. It's on the list of 20 tallest buildings completed in 2011. How does this building, the design of this building, reflect the culture and the identity of Kuwait?
Well, you know, I would just say one of the earlier examples that SOM did in Saudi Arabia, in the Middle East region, is the National Commerce Bank. And that's always been an inspiration in our community. As a how to think of a tall building in very hot desert climate. The climate is similar, culture is different. That's a, you know, we can't just look at it as a broad brush, all Middle Eastern countries, they're very specific, but there is a climatic reference there. And what we when we approached Kuwait, we spent a lot of time with our clients, and we, you know, toured, and SOM also had some prior experience in Kuwait City. One thing is, the ancient building techniques of using masonry, using stone, load-bearing structures, and now we build in skeletal frames. I mean, in Alhambra, it's, you know, a composite structure, but mostly reinforced concrete frame. But what we, the way we looked at it is, we have large shear walls. You know, they are almost like a, I would call it stereotomic part of the building versus the tectonic frame. So what we did is we took the stereotomic mass and clad it, you know, it's all exposed, all in stone, so that there is a sense of robustness to the building where, you know, it, you know, works in harmony with the structure, but also is referential to the robustness of the ancient structures in the region, where there is a sense of sort of belonging to the ground. And the tower does that. I mean, when you go to Kuwait, you look at it and it just sort of, as if its spine grow out of the desert landscape there. But then, you know, the duality of the skeletal frame and the glass skyscraper, that creates a dialogue between what's modern and what is sort of more, let's say, belonging to the context. So the tower's form really evolved out of that. And there's, you know, like a lot of complex problems, there are many things that you go through. There is optimization processes. You'd like to give views. You'd like to, you know, create thermal comfort, the things that we talked about. You have to create an efficient building. You know, you have to create an efficient structure. But also buildings at this scale create, have another function to play. They are, I mean, it's almost the equivalent of Empire State Building, what it did in New York City in the at its time versus this building, Alhambra to Kuwait. So it plays, it's the modern icon. And its unique form generated by a very parametric thinking, but resulted in something very unique. And you know, everyone embraces it there, and we're quite happy about it.
Well, I'll just say that the combination of this with repetition, if you look at the floor plan, for instance, in this tower, it on three of the sides, it's very much the same. And so buildability was important. And I think the complex forms were tackled right from the very beginning with the contractor in terms of coming up with a modeling technique to define it, and then a segmented process, almost like a masonry, as Ibarz is talking about. If you look at the way that those walls were built, they were built like stacked panels, and they were ever so slightly turned to make the form. So it's this concept of stacking and building parts along the height of the building that we worked through and were executed.
Constructability, any special considerations on this one that you wouldn't necessarily run into in another building?
Well, without a doubt, the building is very eccentric under its own weight. So the building has corrections that were built into it during construction to counteract the movement that would happen initially and over time. Since it's a concrete building, it will continue to creep and shrink for a period of time. So we've designed it so that the final resting place, so to speak, is the true position. So very carefully introducing both torsional and vertical corrections along the plan of the building during construction. That was probably the most interesting and perhaps most difficult. And in addition to that, the foundation systems, because of the way the loads hit the base of that tower, we needed to come up with a system that was very, very robust in certain areas. so that we had a, I'll call it a constant distribution of load throughout the foundations as those forces made their way into the piles that were underneath the mat. So you'll have areas of very, very high density of piles and longer piles versus areas where it was spread out. So those are probably the two major issues. And then, you know, the idea of introducing some structural steel composite construction within the concrete was needed, especially at the base of the tower. So perhaps those are the three sort of special components for the construction.
You know, the Alhambra, Fertius Tower in Kuwait City, is one of the tallest buildings in the world, completed in 2011. 413 meters, it's not a small building, and a new icon for Kuwait, one of the finalists in the best tall building competition in the Middle East and Africa. And Ibar's Assi and Mark Sarkeesian from SOM, thanks for coming by to see us.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.